Is that the McBain Company? Says Xena. Did they ever give up? Are they really mere troubadours?
Leave them to me. Go get 'em, wooden soldiers.
I thought it was leave it to you. Oh, that's a bunch. Ten of them? It'd be funny if they jumped and, like, broke through the hole.
Wow! What a great number of soldiers, says Una.
Phew! They filled up alright, Fred says. We gonna fight all of them at once? Adios, the McBain Company.
Hey! Don't run away, says Xena.
Okay, we'll sail away instead. We lost them, says Forte. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, yeah. I don't know if we ever fought 10 enemies at once. Maybe they'll split it into different battles. We can't do anything once they run away, says Fred. We need to choose a strategic withdrawal, otherwise we'll be caught in danger. What a shame, says McBain. But it seems to be the wise decision. Oh, we're just backing off. Okay. Oh, now, says Una.
Shoot, we are surrounded, McBain says.
We have no choice, Ada says. Huh? Phew! Okay, tell me these are easier. Do we have to fight these?
How frustrating, says Ada. How many more are there?
Grandpa, this could go on forever.
Are we all done for, says McBain?
This is a last resort for us. Let's jump in the ocean and escape.
Oh. Is someone shooting cannons from another ship?
They are finally here, says Fred. Oh. Is that who he sent the carrier pigeon off to?
Huh. Subleader Ruka. Yeah, I remember Ruka. Says, don't shoot the humans in harbor facilities.
Aye, aye, sir.
That white ship, says Una.
From the Planetos 2, Forte says.
What precise gunfire, Ada says.
Fred says, that's because it's the best battleship in the world. Okay. Don't aim incorrectly.
Good work, Ruka.
I was worried about you, Captain. I remember Ruka from long ago.
Captain, says Forte.
Una says, so that means you're... Fred just laughs. One day I'm a diplomat at Burrodane. One day I'm a bartender. One day I'm a con man in the novel. But my true identity is someone who runs the Planetos 2 and goes around the seven seas. I'm Captain Thomas.
Ha!
He's from... The Tier of a Million. The second game that was supposed to be the first game. Oh no, it was the second game. Yeah, it was supposed to be the first game. So he's Captain Thomas. And there's his bird. Return to him.
No way, says Forte.
You? Captain Thomas, says Una. Are you serious?
I sort of knew, though, says McBain.
Captain Thomas, says Ada.
Never heard of him.
Don't you know, says Thomas.
Ruka says, Captain, get on, or I'll leave you here.
Jeez. Mutiny. McBain says, we met in Shulf, correct? Mitchell says, long time no see. Oh yeah, here's that guy hanging out up there. By the cliff? I almost forgot. You said you had heard of us from your friend, right? Says Forte. Yes, Thomas told me. Forte says, Mr. Slade is not really Slade, but he is actually Fred, and Fred is Captain Thomas? I'm so confused, says Una. Come on in, says Mitchell. Welcome aboard on the Planetos 2. Make yourself at home, says Thomas. Let's go get Xenon, Thomas says. This is really unexpected, says Forte. Thanks for your help, says Una. We'll get to Numeros quickly with this ship, says McBean. All aboard, says Thomas. Aye, aye, sir. Those who learned of the existence of the evil powers know that the powers of the Resonance Stone are meant to prevent evil. Do not touch the things you'll find ahead. Just remember them deep in your heart and pray for peace and security of the world. Despite Leon's advice, Aria and the Dark Sun were taken by the Numeros army led by Commander Xenon and Necros. Oh, that's right, they got Aria again too. That stinks. Forte and his friends boarded the Planetos 2 with their new companions and headed for the Empire in search of the Numeros warship carrying Aria and the Dark Sun. Chapter 4, Nomad's Interlude, The End. Mitchell says, the source of the bad wave motion that I've been feeling was the Dark Sun. It was our mistake that we let the Numeros find it before we even worked out our countermeasures. The sailor says, Captain, the warships of the Numeros army are headed for to Gazalg. To Gazalg? It's a fishing harbor in the northernmost of Numeros, says Thomas. That means they're intending to take a land route to Kleda. Then let's keep some distance and follow them so that they won't notice. Aye, aye, sir. Or aye, sir. Chapter 5, Dreadful Rhapsody. I wonder where the dogs of Numeros are taking the Dark Sun to, says Thomas. Ruka says, it's not clear yet, but some kind of military factory was built in Kleda lately. I heard a rumor that Rish and pirates, affiliated with Ramon, played as a mediator to help them load resources. Ramon, that bastard, says Thomas. He is picking up jobs here and there, as usual. Wait a minute. No way, says Ada. The factory that produces wooden soldiers? Probably so, says Ruka. Ada says, they took Capuri there and created those wooden soldiers. Forte says, then Xenon and the company must have gone with Aria via the factory in Kleda to take Dark Sun to the capital, Pukasus. Pukasus? What kind of name is that for a place? Capital. McBain says, yeah, this path will lead you to Pukasus, where the castle is. Plus, we still have to find the rest of the resonance stones. This route will prevent us from taking extra time. Capura, Aria, and the Dark Sun, says Thomas. And what's more, we have to look for some more resonance stones. We might as well ask for help. Help? Says Forte. Mitchell says, I assume those two are still in Cavaro. What two? Thomas says, in Cavaro. It's a bit too far, but it's better to have them come now than later. Those two? Says Una. Are they talking about Xiao and Rachel by any chance, Ms. McBain? I was just wondering that.
You guys may have met them in Cavaro, says Thomas.
Yeah, right, Grandpa.
Do you remember those who saved us from the roof of the International Theater when we escaped from Cavaro with Aria?
Oh yeah, I remember them, says Una.
Yeah, those two, says McBain.
Listen, Captain Thomas, I have a question for you, says Forte.
Huh?
Forte, just call me Thomas. Aren't we comrades who fought together?
Yeah, okay then, Thomas.
Who are all those people, aside from those two who saved us in Cavaro?
We are old buddies.
But none of them is from Weltluna, right?
Why do you say that?
When I met Mitchell and Schulf, the way he was talking gave me the impression that he was from beyond the backbone of the Great Serpent. In addition, we have not seen the spell that Thomas uses.
I agree, he's pretty sharp, says Mitchell.
Isn't he? Thomas says.
The two you met in Cavaro and I are from Elfilden. Lap, Mitchell's from Tiras Wheel.
Right.
Okay, so Mitchell, I guess, grows up and gets old to be Grandpa Lap, who you then meet in Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. And I think in A Tear of a Million, he was just called Lap. He was younger. I forget. Yeah, from Tiras Wheel. The two you met in Cavaro and I are from Elfilden.
That makes us all from the other side of the backbone of the Great Serpent.
Oh my, says McBain.
Mitchell is the one who first noticed the catastrophe in Weltluna. Because the expected situation seemed too serious, we got together and decided to come over.
Mitchell says, actually, I separated Thomas, the two from Cavaro and myself, into three groups, and we were investigating on a dark sun in Weltluna.
Thomas says, that's why our paths started to overlap yours when you were searching for the water melody.
Let's see, we gotta go pick up our aides in a hurry after taking you to Gazalg.
Sorry for making you go back and forth, says McBean.
Don't mention it. It won't take a second by the Planetos, too.
Actually, it seems like a lengthy voyage.
Well, anyway, I won't be able to fight with you for a while, but hang in there. I'll catch up with you in Pukasas.
The sailor says, Captain, I see the port of Gazalg.
Good.
Anchor the Planetos 2 where the Numeros army won't find it, and prepare a small boat to go ashore with.
Roger.
Roger, Dodger.
Be careful, says Thomas.
Thank you for everything, Thomas, says McBain.
No, it just started.
Phew,
this tour has turned out to be the busiest journey, McBain says.
Forte and his friends decided to land in the fishing village of Gazalk to avoid the eyes of the Numeros army.
Oh, but we can't look around the ship.
How dare you?
We're here, Thomas says. This is Gazalk.
It seems like it's just a normal village, says Forte.
Well, Numeros has a lot of normal people living here too, you know. But remember, this is Numeros. This is the enemy's heartland. Be careful.
Okay, we'll be careful.
Promise me.
Thomas, you be careful too, says Forte.
Good luck, Thomas says.
Hey, back here.
Where are you thinking going?
Okay, McBain says, let's check on the resonance stone. McBain opens the magic map.
Okay, so here's Gazalg. Down the road, we have Cleda with one in Cleda. Pukasas over there. We'll see Thomas again there. And then the Mirror Cave. Is that it? Is it just three Numeros stones. Three resonance stones left?
Three of them are shining, says Una.
Yes, McBain says. Let's go and collect some information here in Gazalg for now.
Okay. Look around the town.
I seem to
Can't seem to go that way. So if I go here and it goes to the side, it goes... Yeah, we've got invisible stuff in the way here. Nobody home? Okay. You can't get past those trees. Okay. I was thinking maybe we had a tree maze, but no, it's just we can't go that way. Oh yeah, nothing else here. All right. Kiska says, "Hey, you're not from around here, are you? This place has been taken over by soldiers from Bukathus. Don't wander around too much if you want to stay out of trouble." "We're looking for a person," says Forte. "It's a lady named Aria. Do you know her?" Una says, "She's got really long black hair and she's beautiful. Do you know her?" "Long black hair? I wonder if you're talking about the girl that Xenon took away." "Yeah, that's her, probably," says Ada. "They headed over to Cleta." Forte says, "I guess they landed here, too. Let's chase after them and rescue Aria." "Rescue? Forget it," says Kiska. "There are a lot of soldiers around. It's like you're going in there only to get caught." "You look like a bad boy. But you're pretty wimpy, aren't you?" says Ada. "You don't get it, do you? This village has been taken over by soldiers. Right now, the elder's giving money under the table, but if commotion is started here, security will become even tighter. Please don't start anything. I'm having enough trouble as it is with my mom and dad not being here." "Got it?" Well... who woke up on the wrong side of the bed? Okay. Items and weapons. Sheet armor. So sheet armor is armor made with joined sheet metal strips. Very heavy, but offers good protection. An iron shield of Forte? Iron shield molded in an arm shape. The entire arm becomes a shield. Effective. It's pretty cheap, I'll just buy this. That's more expensive. We might have enough for all of it. Bear glove for McBean. Maybe not at all. Curved claws are embedded, produces tearing force in addition to attack power. Alright, we'll get the bear glove. Armor bow. Bow reinforced with steel core. Much force and skill is needed to draw. Alright, we'll buy that. Charge spear for Ada. Don't have money? We haven't been using Ada. Spear with complex blades for piercing and slashing. Short but powerful. So, yeah, I'm gonna wait on this stuff. A broadsword for Forte. Large sword with a thin double-edged... I can't talk. I can't say double-edged blade. Sharp yet difficult to use. Snake sword. Oh, this is the one that hits with flame in addition. So, the exchange. Let's do the exchange. Yeah. Alright. So, equipping the iron shield. Forte's defense going up by 2. McBain with the bear glove. Attack up by 9. Defense by 1. And Una with the armor bow. Attack up by 9 and defense by 1. So now we can sell these things and maybe buy his sword. Sell. Okay, the large shield. Victor glove. Holly bow. We have enough. A broadsword for 4 tang. Wow. Attack up by 14. We should really see a difference with that. Let's sell his snake sword and whatever other sword he was using. Flame sword. Didn't he also holding on to a snake sword? Maybe not. No, alright. We don't have enough for any of the sheet armors. We'll have to come back for that. At least the weapons are upgraded. Oh, this is some lady in here. Kiara says, "Thanks to them, we can't even go shopping in peace." See anything? So let me take a peek at something here. Yeah, I'm looking for the next book. The next book is in Numeros itself, I think. Oh, no. This place is part of Numeros. We're supposed to follow him. Kiska. He'll give us a book. I'm glad I just looked. I had it written down on a post-it. He ran off and then... Oh, he ended up going in here, and then he gives us a book, I guess. This village has been taken over by soldiers. Now that you know, don't wander around too much. Here, read this and make sure you don't get noticed. Doll Knight 20. Yay! Huh? Says Forte. Anyway, don't wander around too much. Alright, so that's great. The next one... It's an item shop outside a wooden soldier factory. It's kind of like small spoilers that I know there's a wooden soldier factory that we're going to go to. But I was just trying to find these books, you know what I mean? Oh, I can just drop off. Even with using the walkthrough, I missed 2 of them. Who's this person running around like crazy? Is that a soldier? Hey, what are you doing? You weren't sent to Clayta? Hmm, fine then. Go home, quickly. What? Alright, never mind. So let's see what's here. Just saying. equator is south, 552 milos. Go away. Civilians aren't allowed to go outside. Damn. Held captive? What are you people doing? You've been told that you aren't allowed to go out. Well, that's not very nice. You have this place under siege or what? My partner is drunk, so he doesn't know what he's doing. And I'm drunk too. Hick. So then you don't know what you're doing. Not enough alcohol here. How come there's no alcohol on my off day? You're already drunk. I think you're okay. I can't stand the abuse from the soldiers. They eat and drink for free every day. Oops. I hope they didn't hear that. I heard that. And there. Okay. Whoa, whoa. It isn't wise to go this way. We have to try to avoid the soldiers as much as possible. Isn't that where we just... Where did we go that way? They wouldn't let us through. I thought it was there. What's over here? Mina says, give us back Dad and Mom. Let us see Mom, says Riraru. Gee, shut up, says the soldier. Hey. Hey, says Ada. What are you doing? Why are you mean to such little kids? Why is she smiling and happy? Who are you? You dare stand against us? This isn't good, Grandpa. Yeah. This isn't good at all. Please stop, says the elder. Or unelder? It's the old man elder, says the soldier. Yes, I am but an old man. Did the children do something wrong? Well, not anything wrong, but they're being obnoxious about giving them back their parents. What? Even after the lecture I gave them? Why don't you understand? Your parents are working for this country. They're in Clayton making wood soldiers. It's a very important job. Right, Mr. Soldier? Yeah, that's right. You understand well. Yes, I do understand. The children understand too. He's just trying to placate them. So, please forgive them. I beg you. The elder gave the soldiers something. As long as you understand, be sure to teach the kids to behave. Will you pay them off or something? Now, Mina and Riraru, go play over there. And? You people, I'm surprised that you got in here. You're lucky that the soldiers let you through. Please leave immediately. What happened to the parents of those children, says Ada. They are being forced to work at the wood soldier factory in Clayta. There's nothing I can do. I'm pretty spry jumping down those stairs. Ada says, I can't just leave those kids alone like that. Did he say at the wood soldier factory, says Forte? We can't leave this problem unsolved after we hear about it, McBain says. I think it's better if we have the elder explain the details. Okay. It reads Soldier's Quarters. Forget it, Forte, says McBean. It's better to avoid the soldiers if we can. At some point, we'll get in there. Right? Oh, there's a chest back here. Orb of Ocean 52. Image of Thomas. Have you talked to him yet? I haven't looked in these places. Grandpa Runald says, "Oh, I wonder how my son and his wife are doing. I'm so lonely." I want to see my mom, says Riraru. I can't walk past him. He blocks my way. Oh, there's a thing there. When will Mommy come home? Is she coming home soon? Says Mina. No idea. Grandma Raccoon says, I can't believe these kids stood up against the soldiers. Oh, no, we've read that already. The Awakening of the Archenemy. I guess it's a pretty important book to keep. I keep running into it. Who are you? Did you come here to get arrested? Yep. Came here to get arrested. It's my only goal in life, to be arrested. Well, that's where the elder is. Kiska. Kiska says, I'll go to Clayta, even by myself. I'm gonna tear the Wood Soldier Factory apart. Then Mom and Dad can come back. No, you may not. You must stay here and wait for news from Sir Ector. He's too slow. I can't wait any longer. Oh, crap. Una says, what's wrong? Nothing. Okay. Kiska! Oh, you're the people I saw. We have something we want to ask you, says Una. We're worried about those kids we saw earlier, Ada says. You were defending Mina and Rarari, weren't you? Please, come in. The bad luck for this village started when Emperor Rousen built a Wood Soldier factory in Clayta. The people from Gazalg and Clayta were pressed into work at the factory. The young, capable people were all sent to Clayta, and the only ones left here are children and the elderly. The parents of Mina and Riraru you saw earlier have been taken to Clayta and haven't returned. Ada says, so that's why Kiska was saying that he's going to Clayta? Yes, he's such a strong-headed boy. Even if I tell him to wait for Sir Ector's return, he won't listen. Who's Sir Ector? Asked Forte. He's the only ally that we have. He's the rightful prince of Numeros. He was supposed to be emperor. Huh? Says Una. Then what about the current Emperor Rousen? He deceived the royal family and became the emperor about 8 years ago. Sir Ector has infiltrated the Wood Soldier factory in Clayta in order to put an end to Rousen's malicious plans and to save us. It's about time Sir Ector has contacted us in some way. I can't do anything except be monitored here by the soldiers and wait for contact from Sir Ector. Kiska has every right to be upset at me. Hey, Grandpa Mac. I wonder if Kiska is okay. I wonder if he went to Clayta on his own.
Oh, you're right.
He was pretty upset a while ago, says McBean. We should go and search for him, Forte says. Elder, we'll go and check up on Kiska.
Yes, please do so. Kiska is a very strong-headed boy. Please find him as soon as you can.
Oh, he's got like a downstairs area we can check out. Pretty empty. Okay. Alright. Yep. It's our dream to be arrested by such as you. Why does it go this way? But we have to go to Clayta. You don't understand. Is there another way to leave? Wait a second. Ah! He's here. Okay. Actually been running for quite a while. I'm gonna call an episode here. We'll talk to this kid again and we'll go to Clayta next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.